Welcome all friends in the Dhamma. Stay calm and wake up. Many practitioners stay calm but not wake up. So wake up. You need to develop the first power or the first faculty. There are five faculties or five power. Trust in the Buddha. This is the first power.Right effort, okay. This is the second power, okay. And mindfulness, the third power. Meditation, the sixth power, the fourth power. And number fifth is wisdom. Normally, people practicing only number three, four, and five, they don't pay more importance on the number one and number two. Today, I just let you try to start with number one and number two first. Don't do anything. Only trust in the Buddha with recollection of the Buddha virtue, number one. Okay? Don't do any practice. Number one first.Trust in the Buddha with recollection of the Buddha virtue. You got feeling nice breathing. You got feeling relaxing. And then number two, right effort to let go, right resolve, okay? And right effort withSmiling and loving kindness. Now, number two. Can you do only number one, number two? Then number three will come up by itself. Number four come up by itself. And more you got number one, two, three, four. Balancing number five, wisdom come up by itself. Because when you got trust and recollection of the Buddha virtue,You cannot do bad. You cannot feel bad. You cannot keep anything with attachment in your heart for long. Whatever you keep as burden in your heart for a week, a month, when you got trust and recollect the Buddha virtue, you cannot do it. Cannot. Okay? Cannot do it, actually.So, before you do meditation practice, number four, mindfulness practice, number three, vipassana practice, number five, can you start with trust and recollect the Buddha virtue first? Everything will be very natural. Number one, with eye opening.Trust and recollect of the Buddha virtue. You feel more consciousness because you fulfill with my consciousness with trust and recollection of the Buddha virtue. Then it's open eye consciousness, it's open ear consciousness, it's open tongue consciousness, it wake up. Eye consciousness wake up, ear consciousness wake up, tongue consciousness wake up, nose consciousness wake up, body consciousness.If you got your mind consciousness wake up with trust and recollection of the Buddha virtue. As long as you can, 2-3 minutes, 5 minutes before you do any practice. The inner consciousness wake up. Mind consciousness wake up.Eye consciousness wake up, ear consciousness wake up, nose consciousness wake up, tongue consciousness wake up, the whole body consciousness refreshing and wake up. And trust in the Buddha virtue. The Mahakaruna, the great compassion of the Buddha, okay? Wisdom of the Buddha and the purity of the Buddha. So when you trust and recollect the Buddha wisdom, you got Buddha wisdom, seeing anicca immediately. Okay, this is anicca, this person. Bring all the Buddha worship, okay? Great compassion, okay, and purity and wisdom, seeing things as they really are. Wisdom, wisdom of the Buddha. Just welcome Buddha, wisdom come to your heart. Buddha Ma, you see already anicca dukkhang anatta. And then with number one, then you got number two, because you fulfill with number one, trust and recollect the Buddha virtue. You cannot do bad. You cannot think bad. You cannot feel bad. You let go all unwholesome feeling in your heart. Let go. Let go. It let go by itself. Now, in your life now, we don't know how long we live. So your heart with the Buddha, trust and recollect the Buddha worship, and the Buddha will bring you on the path. Now you got number one, then you got number two. All release, unwholesome feeling release, attachment release, desire release, and trust and recollect the Buddha more and more as you can. You can feel consciousness inside, wake up to your eye consciousness, brightness, ear consciousness, clearness, okay? Tongue consciousness, nose consciousness, body consciousness, more awareness. And then this is your spiritual consciousness, okay? Spiritual consciousness, or your inner consciousness, or spiritual, or inner consciousness. We can say spiritual, that is inner consciousness according to Theravada. Theravada use the word consciousness. Okay? Mind consciousness, body consciousness, tongue consciousness, nose consciousness, ear consciousness, body consciousness. This is Theravada use the word consciousness. But sometimes, those practitioners that use the word spiritual. And what is spiritual? Okay. Because in Theravada, no spirit. Okay. No spirit. We only have consciousness. Okay. Spiritual is still okay. But in Theravada, no spirit. Only consciousness. Okay. So then we say, we got wake up with fully consciousness, full consciousness. And then it look like your inner consciousness expanding. This is the consciousness, not pure. If pure, then go to Nippon. Now not pure, then sometimes go to hell, go to heaven. Not pure. If pure consciousness, then you don't have to practice anything. You go to Nippon already, pure consciousness. So stay aware. Stay calm, stay aware. Consciousness don't practice anything. Consciousness, we use the words stay calm, stay aware. Okay? Stay calm, stay aware. That's why I tell you stay calm. Because I would like you to go to do meditation from consciousness. From consciousness, you cannot practice meditation. You only stay calm. And next, stay aware. Stay calm and stay aware. If you wake up, then stay calm and stay aware. Stay mindful. Don't have to practice mindfulness. Stay mindful. Okay? Stay. And only trust in the Buddha more and more. Recollect the Buddha worship. Don't do anything. If you do calmness, do meditation, do mindfulness, the Buddha worship not wake up, because is your worship, not the Buddha worship. It's your worship. You got very poor calmness, very poor poor mindfulness, poor awareness. This is your virtue. Okay. So if you got number one, trust in the Buddha. Recollect the Buddha virtue. You don't need to chant Buddha, or you want to chant Buddha, okay. Or you want to chant Itibiso. Doesn't matter what you're chanting. The matter is you got recollect the Buddha virtue or not. Now stay calm. Stay calm. Your consciousness cannot do with stillness. When you come, you got more consciousness, it become more no self, only stay calm, stay aware, stay mindful. And what you see now, you will see the character of this person. Boop, bop, boop, bop, boop, bop, boop, bop, character. Character of the physical body. Movement or rising, falling, rising, falling. So better we use the word seeing your character. Now you sit this way, or you sit this way, or you sit this way, or whatever your character. Because when you stay calm, stay aware, what happening? You cannot do meditation. You only see this the character of this person and see the truth. Anicjang, Thukkhang, Anatta. Because you go back to your spiritual consciousness already. You beyond practicing already. You get good result already. See characteristic. The three characteristics. How to see a characteristic. That's why don't try to see characteristic. Just see character of this person. Then you can see characteristic. Because now you wake up with consciousness, even you try to see anicjang, try to see anatta, cannot do. What you can do only see what you see, how you sit, how you walk, how you doing, okay? How you eating? Can you see your own character when you eating? We only see this person. We see character. Character of this person, what you find, the character of this person. Three characteristics. Then it turned up to you. Anicjang, Thukkhang, and Anatta. So this session, you only see character of this person, of the five aggregate. More you see character of this person, you can sometimes you see into four element, sometimes you see into five aggregate. Okay, make it easy. See character only. Okay. Don't have to think what to do next, because when you already wake up with consciousness, you cannot do any practice from stillness. You only accept and see things as they are. What you see now? I only see my own character, and my own character show me. When I not doing anything, I sit still, but actually this body not still, got rising, falling everywhere. Okay, so we start from this we call Kayakata Sati. Okay? Kayakata Sati, mindfulness of body. See how the body is, okay? And now, make sure you got the Buddha, the collection. And trust in the Buddha with right effort and see character. Then you can close your eye. When you close your eye, you only see character of your sitting, or see character of the physical body. You see how it functions, rising, falling, cool, warm, sweat. You see character, everything will turn up to you, turn up to you. Manifestation as for the man, manifestation as movement. You already see character already. You will get manifestation of this character of this person as for the man, as fire aggregate, as movement, rising, falling, as breathing. So this session today, only stay calm and mindful, stay mindful and see this person, this person character, and close your eye. Only see character of this person. And the result is three characteristics. Anicjang, Dukkhang, Anatta. That is the result. Don't have to try to see the three characteristics. Because three characteristics is the manifestation of good mindfulness and awareness of this person's character. Don't have to think first, anicjang, dukkhang, anatta, see character and find out by your own manifestation. See character. What you see? Sometimes you see stomach rising, falling. Sometimes you see the whole body rising, falling. Sometimes you see breathing. Sometimes you see together breathing and rising, falling. So if you stay calm and mindful with your consciousness, you cannot do anything more than this. Because what you do is only you do from self-ness. With no self, you only see the present moment, character of this person. Everything will happen by itself. See character of this person. See character of sitting posture. Now it become seeing things as they really are, or vipassana. Seeing character, don't think about vipassana. See character, because vipassana will happen when you got seeing the three characteristic. Okay, how to see characteristic? See character. Character of this person. Normally, you not see character of this person, but you try to see the three characteristic: anicca, tukkhang, and anatta. Only see character. Or mindfulness of body or kayakata sati. How to develop kayakata sati? Seeing character of this person. Only this enough, good enough already. So you can see different manifestation at four dimensions sometimes, at stomach movement sometimes, at the whole body rising, falling sometimes, or all together with all movement and breathing, inhale and exhale, you only see this collector. Then everything work by itself, breathing work by itself, stomach rising, falling work by itself, body rising, falling by itself, four element cool or warm work by itself. Just see character. Stay calm and mindful, seeing the character of this person at the present moment. It show suffering. It show anicca. It show anatta. It show by itself. If you not involved, if you try to see anicca, tukkhang, anatta, you cannot see clearly because you got involved. Okay, you got involved. Not involved, seeing character. Stay calm and mindful with fully consciousness, seeing character of this person only. Not do anything. Only trust in the Buddha and recollect the Buddha worship. When you see character, the result is three characteristics. Three characteristic is the result of seeing character. And more you see character and the result characteristic, more you got trust in the Buddha. Because you realize the same thing as the Buddha discover the three characteristics. That's why the Buddha is the first one, maybe in long time, one Buddha enlightened and see the characteristic. Three characteristic that is the teaching of the Buddha. And the main teaching of Theravada Buddhism. People try to reflect, try to think, but today, not try to reflect, try to think about three characteristics, but see the present moment of this person's character in sitting posture. Only enough. And trust with the collection of the Buddha virtue. What you see, you got seeing from the Buddha virtue, okay? Because you already got Buddha mind in your heart. Then what you see is the same what the Buddha discovered, or the same as the Buddha teaching, the teaching to this world. The law of three characteristics, only in Buddhism, only the law of three characteristics. Don't have to practice anything. Only seeing character of this person, then it will got manifestation to you, the reality, the three characteristics. Sometimes you see four elements. Sometimes you see breathing. Sometimes you see rising, falling. Sometimes you see breathing and rising, falling, and four elements together. This is what you see. Don't have to think, don't have to choose, only see and accept. Accept character of this person. Then you got characteristic, the three characteristics as the result. And your heart open, open with the Buddha. Virtue with the Buddha, wisdom and purity from the Buddha, great compassion. Now your heart with Buddha, everything well done already. Don't have to think what to practice. More your heart become one with the Buddha, you got equanimity of mind. And then you can see character even of your mind inside. We call sensation, that is character of mind, okay? Sensation is movement. That is my movement, character, or my web, my web, okay? The sound got web, okay? The light got web. Sensation is the web of the mind or the character of the mind. Only see character and learn to understand, accept, and let go or attachment. See character of the body first. more you see character of this person, then you can see into the Dhamma, character of the body, character of the mind. See character, that is to see what happened to this body, to this person. Only the three characteristics happen to this person. And before we finish this session, just review how calmness is. Just review how seeing character of this person and what is the characteristic of this person. Just review. You see character of this person more, you can see this person got heat, got temperature, got everything. And now just share merit to everybody in your family, in your country, with loving kindness. Let everybody be healthy, overcome the COVID-19, and God well-being. And now just smile to yourself for your good health, happiness, and all success. And we finish today's session.